Kailangan mo lang ng, ito tulad niya, how much is the cash from operating, investing, financing? Madali lang yan. Okay? Ito, gamitin natin itong template na to. Okay. Pag sinabi natin cash flow, these are what? The inflow and outflow of cash and cash equivalents. So, ibig sabihin, para ma-master mo ang cash flow, kailangan alam mo yung concept ng cash and cash equivalents na pinag-usapan na natin dati pa. Okay? Then, there are three activities under cash flows. You have the operating activities, the investing activities, and the financing activities. Okay, ito yung sinasabi ng libro. Kapag the operating activities, those are the transactions that affect the profit or loss. And investing activities are transactions, no, affecting your non-current assets and non-operating assets. And under financing activities, these are the affected transactions, accounts, the non-current liabilities, non-operating liabilities, and items affecting equity. Okay? Madali ito. Bakit? Kasi alam mo yung tatama sa profit or loss. Alam mo si non-current assets. Alam mo si non-current liabilities. At alam mo ang components ng equity. Saan siya humihirap? Dito. Sa non-operating assets tsaka non-operating liabilities. Diyan siya humihirap. Diyan tayo nagkakamali. Okay? Kaya yan, tatanggalin ko. Pupunta tayo dito sa template natin. Ano naman ito? Lahat ng tumama nung nag-compute ka ng net income after tax, that is an operating activity. Tandaan mo yun. Lahat ng tumama sa pag-compute ng net income after tax, syempre, definitely cash transactions ito. Nasa cash flow tayo. No? Yan ay operating activities. Okay. Sa investing siya, sa investing ganito class, tatanungin mo kung may pera ka. Di ba? Bakit ka ba nag-i-invest? Nag-i-invest ka kasi may pera ka. Ayun. Investing activity yon. Example. Okay. Bumili ka ng equipment. Okay? May pera ka? Yes. So that is an investing activity. Nakuha. Ingat. Then, pag dinispose mo yung equipment na yon, pag dinispose mo yung equipment na yon, it will not change its classification. That would still be considered as investing activity. Okay? And daya mo, sir. Eh. Sabi mo, first transaction mo, purchase of equipment, acquisition. Then, next transaction mo, disposal. Eh, sir, kita yon. Eh, kasi, sir, dun sa mga sinasolve kong problems, ganito nakalagay. Nakalagay lang disposal eh, ng equipment. Oh, wala namang sinabing purchase. How would I classify that? Ganito yan. Kapag nakita ka ng disposal of equipment, i-correlate mo. Bakit ka may equipment? Okay? Ang assumption, kasi nung unang panahon, bumili ka ng equipment. May pera ka ba nun? Yes. So that is what? Investing activity din. Then the disposal now would not change its classification. That is also an investing activity. Okay? Ganun lang yun. How about financing? Financing naman, wala kang pera. Oh, bakit ka nasa banko? Kasi wala kang pera, sir. Oh, nangungutang ka. So, ibig sabihin, loans from a bank is a financing activity because wala kang pera. And listen, the payment of the amortization of which the payment of the amortization of which will not change its classification. Okay? So meaning, pag nagbayad ka ng amort, still financing activity yun. May nakalimutan ako dito. And other items affecting equity. Okay? Wala kang pera dito, financing activity, and the payment of the amortization of the loan is still a financing activity. No? And you have your items affecting equity. Wala naman tayong problema eh sa items affecting equity kasi kabisado natin ang components ng stockholders' equity. Yan yun. So, yan yung gagamitin mong template to properly classify the transactions. Okay, punta tayo dito. Yan. So I need now your participation here. Ika-classify natin itong mga accounts na to. Okay? So ibig sabihin, ang itatype mo sa chat box, initial ng activity. Let's say you have the operating activity. That operating activity dapat letter O. Then, investing activity letter I. Then, you have your financing activity letter F. Okay, so this is the Tika account of cash. Therefore, these are cash transactions. Let's begin. How would you classify sales? Diba sabi ko nga, lahat nga. So chat box tayo. How would you classify sales? Lahat nga ng tumama sa pag-compute ng net income after tax ay operating. So this is operating. Okay? How would you classify interest income? Lahat nga. Okay? Ng ginamit mo sa pag-compute ng net income after tax ay operating. How about rent income? Lahat nga eh. Nang ginamit mo sa pag-compute ng net income after tax ay operating. Dividends income? Lahat nga. Okay? Nang ginamit mo sa pag-compute ng net income after tax ay operating. Eto class, this will be the last item to be discussed. Okay? Pumasok kasi si PFRS 9. Eto. Let's go here. Sale of old building. Oh, bakit ka may old building? What is the assumption? Kasi nung unang panahon, bumili ka ng building na yan. May pera ka ba nun? Yes. So anong classification niya dati? Investing activity. Now, the disposal of this building which will not change its classification. Therefore, the sale of old building is what? Classification. Investing. Okay? Isulat mo ha, kasi mamaya total lang kailangan natin. Oh. Collection of non-trade note. Bakit ka nangangolekta ng non-trade note? Kasi ano ba yung mother na ano nito, na transaction? Nung unang panahon, nagpautang ka, may pera ka ba nun? Yes or no? May pera ka ba nun? Yes or no? Nung nagpautang ka nung unang panahon, yes. Ibig sabihin, what classification is that? Yes, that is investing activity. Therefore, the collection of the note will not change its classification. Still, this is what? An investing activity. Nakuha. Next, proceeds from bank loan. Bakit ka nasa banko? Kasi wala kang pera. And you need what? You need financing. So, proceeds from bank loan is what? This is a financing activity. How about this insurance of shares? This is an equity item. Issuance of shares is an equity item. Therefore, this is a financing activity. Let's now go to the credit side. Okay. Purchases. And lahat nga ng ginamit mo sa pag-compute ng net income after tax operating. So operating ito. Pag may nagkamali sa kasunod, uwian na. Okay? Ano yan? Operating expenses. Oh, this is operating activity. Okay? Next, how about in interest expense? Lahat nga ng ginamit mo sa pag-compute ng net income after tax ay operating. So, operating. Income taxes, lahat nga ng ginamit mo sa pag-compute ng net income after tax ay operating. So, this is also operating. Next, investment in FVOCI. May pera ka ba? Yes. Ibig sabihin, this is investing. Purchase of equipment. May pera ka ba? Yes. So, therefore, this is investing. Loan granted to employee. May pera ka ba dyan? Yes or no? Loan granted to employee. Ikaw yung nagpapahiram. Ibig sabihin, that is what? Investing. Okay? Next, payment of loan borrowed. Bakit ka nagbabayad ng loan? Kasi nung unang panahon, wala kang pera. And nung unang panahon, that is financing activity. Nakuha. And the payment of the loan will not change its classification. Therefore, this is what? Payment of loan borrowed is a financing activity. Reacquisition of shares. Yes, this is a component of your equity. Therefore, this is financing activity. And the dividends is a component of your equity coming from or an item that is in nature nasa retained earnings. Therefore, this is financing activity. Okay? So let's now go to the last account na hindi na-discuss. Sale of, this is a sale of held for trading securities. Kasi yan, i-correlate natin yan sa investment. Trading securities, under what classification under FRS 9? This is fair value to profit or loss. Nakuha. And the selling of a fair value to profit or loss investment, any gain or loss of that would be accounted under profit or loss. Therefore, this sale of held for trading securities of 1.6 million, okay, is an account that is used. Okay? In what? In the that is used in the profit or loss. Meaning this account has been considered in computing for the net income after tax. If that is the case, what classification would this fall? This is under operating activity because this is an account that is used when you've computed the net income after tax. If that is the case, can you please compute, class, how much now is the net cash flow under operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities? In the next 30 seconds, please post your answers in the chat box. In order, ah, okay? So, tatlo yun. So, dalawang comma, an amount, comma, and another amount, and in order that is operating, investing, and financing. In the next 30 seconds to 1 minute, please post your answers in the chat box. Your time starts now. Okay, so I'm seeing answers now, no? So, operating activity, that is 4,060. That is an inflow, positive. Then, investing activity, that is negative 1.5 or an outflow of cash, 1.5. And your financing activity is 4,080. Okay, that is an inflow of cash, positive. Did you get that those three answers? Pareho ba kayo? Dito sa nakapost sa ating chat box. Okay? So, 4,060, negative 1.5, and positive 4,080. Kung yan ang mga sagot ninyo, itry natin kung yan nga ang tamang sagot. Okay? What is the net cash flow then? So, can you please account 4,060 minus 1.5 plus 4,080. What is the net cash flow? Ano lumalabas sa kalkyo mo? 4,080 minus 1.5 plus 4,060 minus 1.5 plus 4,080. Magkano amount na lumalabas sa kalkyo mo? Chat box please. Sige. So, gawin natin. So, 4,060 minus 1.5 plus 4,080. Ang lumalabas sa kalkyo ko, 6,640. Ganon din ba ang nasa kalkyo mo? Y or, yan, yes or no, Y or N. Yan, no? 6,640. Okay? Tama, did you get that 6,640? Okay. So, 6,640, what is our beginning balance? 400. So, 6,640 plus 400, magkano? 6,640 plus 400, what is the total? So, that is 7,040. Is that our ending balance? Is that our ending balance sa T-account natin? Check ko nga. Okay. Cash flow. Yun, 7,040. Tama. Okay? So, the answers are, again, positive 4,060 here. Inflow. No? Next, investing negative 1.5. So, outflow. And your number 3, financing, is also an inflow of 4,080. Okay? So, yun. That is your problem 1. What about problem 2? Ang dami na. Pero alam mo, madali lang yan. Okay? Huwag ka ma-overwhelmed lagi sa mahabang problem. Kasi nadadissect naman ito. And that would be the approach in auditing problems. Pag binigyan ka, di ba, auditing problems na ang nature niya, no? Ginagamit ko kasi ito sa mga integrated review na ODPROG. Kaya makikita mo, series of questions na siya. Okay? So, ibig sabihin, pag ganyan, nadadissect naman kasi ito. Oh, let's move to Excel. Madami eh. Madami ito. Kaya kailangan Excel tayo. Okay. So, ito siya. Oh. Yan. Oh, tingnan mo. So, number one is cash receipts. Saan mo makukuha yung cash receipts? Eh, di nandito. Sa accounts receivable mo. Diba, nandun yung collections. Okay? So, correction, no? This should only be sales on account. 32,000. Hindi siya end cash sales. Ayusin mo yung materials mo, ha? Sales on account, 32,000. Game. So, kaya naman. Computin ang collections here. Using the T account of AR. Okay. Game. Beginning. The net sales on account. The ending balance here. The collections. And the write-off. Okay. Ito mga kailangan natin. What is the beginning? 2,400. Okay? Then, ending balance, 1,600. Given. Next, we have the sales on account, 32,000. As corrected, di ba? 32. Then, write-off. May write-off ba? Additional info here says, there were no write-offs of accounts receivable during the year. So, zero ang write-off. So, may squeeze na natin siya. So, 2,400. That's 32,000 minus 1,600. This is the answer. Okay, 32,800. Nga lang mag-ingat ka dyan. Okay, tandaan mo, di ba, nung nasa cash to accrual tayo, okay, yun yung cash receipts mo eh. Cash receipts what? Collections. Collections from what? Collections from regular customers and collection from recovery. Tandaan mo yan. Nagkataon lang na wala kasing recovery dito. Kung may recovery dito sa problem natin, ibig sabihin, mali yung sagot mong 32,800 lang. Kasi that is only the collection from regular customers. Okay? Kailangan mo pa ng collection from recovery. Bakit mo, sir, nasabing walang recovery? Unang-una, walang sinabi. Pangalawa, walang write-off. Eh, pag walang write-off, edi wala rin recovery. Nakuha. So, the answer in number 4, cash receipts, the answer is 32,800. Next, magkano ang cash payments to suppliers? Okay, cash payments to suppliers. The cash payments to suppliers, you have the accounts payable T account. You need the accounts payable T account here. Okay, to determine now the cash payments to suppliers. Okay. So, what we need here is the accounts payable T account. Ang kailangan mo, payments. Oh, di ba? Nandito si payments. AP, beginning here. Then, you have the ending here. The ending here. Then, you have the net purchases here. Okay? Then, you have the payments here. Okay? Yan yung kailangan natin. So, you have here, accounts payable beginning, this is 1,400. Okay? Then you have the ending, you have your 800 here. Okay? Then, sabi niya dito, cost of sales, increase inventory na. Ibig sabihin, yung net purchases hindi niya binigay, i-derive mo to dun sa paborito mong formula na ano, dun sa cost of sales. Kasi nandun yung net purchases mo. Diba? Beginning plus net purchases, total goods available for sale, minus ending, that is your cost of sales. Anong binigay niya? cost of sales. Sabi niya, may cost of sales daw na 16,000 here. So, ilatag natin. So, the cost of sales, 16,000. Then, sabi niya, increase in inventory, 3,600. Eh, di ba, ang sabi natin, increase in account is considered to be as the ending balance of an account. So, the increase in inventory of 3,600 would be your ending inventory here of 3,600. Your beginning is 0. Okay? So, kaya na ba? Yes, kaya nang i-squeeze. That is 16,000 plus 3,600. That would be your work back tayo eh. So, 16,000 plus 3,600. This is 19,600. Eh, 0 din naman yun. So, therefore, your net purchases is 19,600. Okay? Meaning, this would be the amount that should be provided here. 19,600. Then you can now squeeze this amount. That is 14 plus 19,600 minus 800. The answer now is 20,200. Those are now your payments, cash payments to suppliers. Answer in item 5. Okay? Let's now move. Magkano ang cash payments on operating expense? Ito, nakita mo na? Operating expense accrual basis. Increase in accrued payable. Accrued payable for operating expense. Yan yung sinasabi ko. Despite that the cash to accrual basis is not anymore provided in the syllabus of FAR. However, those topics are preparatory topics for cash flows. Kung hindi mo yan naaral, hindi mo na ito masasagot. Diba? Okay? So, gagamit tayo ng template dyan. What are the two accounts now that is being provided here? You have the payable, no? Okay, ito, operating expense on accrual basis. You have the accrued payable and the prepaid operating expense. Diba ito rin yung ginagamit natin kanina? So what are the accounts here? You have the prepaid operating expense and the accrued payable. Okay? These are related to what? These are related to expenses. Other items of expense. Okay? So ano yung accounts na nakikita natin dito? The prepaid operating expense and the accrued payable. Ito na yon. Okay? E di magte-template na tayo yung ginagawa natin kanina. Prepaid operating expense is an asset. So the normal balance is a debit balance. So this is beginning prepaid operating expense and we have the ending prepaid operating expense here. Okay? The ending prepaid operating expense. Ending prepaid operating expense. Yan. Next, we have the accrued payable, which is a liability. The normal balance is a credit balance. So this is now beginning accrued payable and the ending accrued payable. And one of these sides is cash basis and the other is accrual basis. At anong sabi natin? Yun na nga. These are other operating expense and expenses are meant to be paid. So, kine-credit natin ng cash. What is to be debited? These two accounts. Meaning, whenever that there is cash involved, these two accounts are debited. Kaya nandito si cash basis. So, pag nandyan si cash basis, syempre nandun na si accrual basis. Okay, what is the requirement? Cash payments and operating expense. So, etong hinahanap. Okay, the one that has involvement and of cash. Okay, plot the figures. Operating expense, accrual basis, 4880. Ito yon. Next, we have the increase in accrued payable for operating expense. Increase is denoted as the ending balance of an account. Meaning, this is your ending. And what is your beginning? That is zero. Okay, zero. Na naging 1,640, ano nangyari? Nag-increase. By how much? 1,640, and that is exactly the information here. Increase in accrued payable for operating expense, 1,640. Then we have the decrease in prepaid operating expense. And decrease is what? Denoted as the beginning balance of an account. Okay? So decrease in prepaid operating expense, 1,560, that is decrease, so that should be assumed to be the beginning balance of an account. So this is how much? 1,560. And what is the ending? the ending is 0. 1,560 naging 0, ano nangyari? Nag-decrease. By how much? 1,560, which is exactly the provided information here. Okay? So, wala na. Yun na, squeeze mo na to. So, magkano to? That is 4,880 minus 1,560 minus 1,640. There you go. That is your answer. 1,680. Okay? Tatlo ka na. Ito pang isa. How much now is the cash payments for the acquisition of PPE? Siyempre, nasa T-account tayo ng PPE. Ito yon. Cash payments for the acquisition. Eh, di ba ang PPE, ito lang naman siya. Beginning mo, ito. Ending mo, ito. Okay? Tapos ano yung dito? Di ba acquisition? Ano yung nasa kabila? Eh, di ba disposal? Okay? So, ano kailangan mo? Ito, yung acquisition. Okay? So, beginning niya, 7,200. Okay? Then, ending niya, 10,800 given. Okay? Kailangan natin disposal. Nasaan yon ang information about the disposal to account for the answer? Ito, bullet 2. The equipment with accumulated depreciation of 600,000 was sold for 480, resulting to a gain of 60. Okay? If we will plot this, ang sabi niya, meron ka raw equipment with accumulated depreciation of 80. It was sold for 480. So the selling price is 480. And the result of the transaction is what? 60. Okay? That is a gain of 60. Therefore, kung i-squeeze mo to, 480 versus 60, meron niyang carrying value na 420. Yan ngayon yung 420,000 ng disposal mo. Carrying value of the equipment, no, dispose. Okay? Pero pag yung 420 ang ginamit mo dito, magkakamali ka. Bakit? That is the carrying value. What we need is the cost of the equipment disposed. Ano ba ang carrying value? Di ba you have your cost minus the accumulated depreciation. Oh, itong 420, ito yun, yung 420 dito. Okay? And the accumulated depreciation provided yan. Ang sabi niya, the equipment with an accumulated depreciation of 80. Ito yun. Therefore, the cost of the equipment disposed, work back tayo. That is 420 plus 800. That is 1,220,000. Yan yung gagamitin mo dito. Okay? The cost of the equipment disposed is 1,220,000 here. 1,220 lang pala. Okay? Yun. So, yun. May squeeze mo na to. So, that is 10,800 plus 1,220 minus 7,200. There you go. The amount of cash payment for the acquisition of PPE, that is 4,820. Okay? That is your problem. So, madali lang, no? Kasi, idadisect mo lang. Huwag kang ma-overwhelm sa problem dito. What is the key points here? Key points 1, your cash receipts should always be a combination of cost collection from regular customers plus collection from recoveries. Nagkataon kasi na walang recovery here. Kaya this 32,800 is already the answer. If there is a recovery given, therefore this is not yet the answer, then the recovery should be included as part of your cash receipts. Next key points here. If you're asked to compute for the cash payment for the acquisition of PPE, okay, the disposal of which, that should be the disposal of the cost of the equipment. Okay? Not the carrying value. Because you have a separate account for accumulated depreciation under a statement of financial position. Okay? Ano ba? Then, you have to master the technique in cash to accrual basis. Just like what? The one here, no? Yan. Kailangan master mo yan na hindi ka ganong nag-iisip at na kinukompleto mo lang ang sudoku. Okay? So, that would be the nature ng pag-solve mo lagi. Pag nakita mo itong cash receipts, kahit hindi mo nakikita yung problem, okay, alam mo na kung ano gagawin. Cash payments to suppliers, alam mo na kung ano gagawin. Payments for operating expense, alam mo na ang gagawin. as well as the last item. Okay? So, next. Next is what? Ayan, tinatanong niya ngayon yung cash receipts. O, tandaan mo. Under cash receipts, total cash receipts is what? That should be the collections from regular customers and collections from recoveries. Yan yung kailangan natin. Okay, collections from regular customers and collection from recoveries. That would account for the answer. Not necessarily the collection only that is found in the T account of your AR. Okay, gawin natin. Tingnan mo. So, cash receipts, alam na natin yan, na nasa AR yan. Okay, let's do the component of your AR. You have the beginning here. You have the net sales on account here. You have the collections here. You have the write-off here. And you have the ending balance here. Okay? So, accounts receivable beginning, that is 100,000. Ending balance is 250,000. Then, net credit sales. Allowance for bad debts, bakit kaya binigay? Kasi walang write-off, no? So, the write-off can be squeezed under allowance for doubtful accounts. Net credit sales, you have 850,000 here. 850,000. Imask ko lang to. Okay, 850,000. Yan, so wala ka nitong write-off. So this write-off, nandito yan sa allowance for doubtful accounts T account. The normal balance is a credit. This is beginning. Ito, babalik tayo sa receivables. No? Beginning, you have your ending here. Then you have your write-off here. Then you have your recoveries here. Then you have your doubtful accounts here. Okay? Diba yan yung T account natin sa AFDA? Okay? Beginning daw is 15,000. Ending is 20,000. Then, bad debt expense, 60,000. That is your doubtful account expense. And the recoveries of 60,000 pesos. Okay? Or 20,000 pesos, I mean. Therefore, you can squeeze what is the amount written off? That is 15,000 plus 60,000 plus 20,000 minus 20,000. That would account for 75,000. And this is your 75,000 here. Okay? Then, squeeze. That is 100,000 plus 850,000 minus 250 minus 275. Then, this will now be 625,000 pesos. Okay? However, that 625, if you would answer that, may lalabas na sagot. But this is not the answer. Why? Because total cash receipts involves what? The total collection of cash. And the collections will come from regular customers and collections from recoveries. Again, recoveries is not included as part of the T account of AR because nag-offset. The first entry is debit, AR, credit allowance for doubtful accounts. And the second entry would be debit cash, credit AR. Nag-offset, nag-debit and credit, kaya you cannot see the effect of the recovery here. If that is the case, what should be the final answer here? Okay, if 625 is not the answer, what is now the total cash receipts that should be provided as answer in item 8? Chat box, please. Magkano dapat? Okay, that should be, yes, that should be 645,000 pesos. Because the entry here is what? Debit cash, credit, you know, you have your cash here. Okay, the entry for that, that is debit cash, credit AR of 625,000. And remember, the entry here, you have your two entries, the debit AR and credit allowance for doubtful accounts. And the second entry for recovery, that is debit cash and credit AR. Okay, the total amount of cash receipts then, you have your cash here of 625 and a cash here of 20. The answer is 645,000 pesos. Okay? Then we'll move here. What is this indirect method? Okay, indirect method, concept tayo. Okay, let's move to again, to the concept mo. Okay. Under indirect method, dalawa, Plus, ang direct tsaka indirect method sa operating activities lang yun, ha? Walang direct tsaka indirect method sa ano, sa financing tsaka investing. Okay. So, direct method is direct. Kapag may inflow ng cash, i-add mo. Kapag may outflow ng cash, ibawas mo. Ganun lang yun. Paano yung indirect method? Indirect in the sense. Indirect. Dumadaan ka saan? Sa likod. Sa back door. Meaning, nag-i-start ka saan? Sa accrual basis. Yung pinakita sa income statement mo na net income after tax. Okay? Ito kasi, may mga transaction na walang cash involvement. Ano yan? Yung mga non-cash expense tulad ng depreciation expense. Diba? Yan ay nagpababa dito sa net income reported in the income statement. However, there is no involvement of cash. Ang kailangan lang natin is the net income that is purely cash transactions. So all non-cash expenses that decreases the net income after tax should be added back. Ito na yun. Ayan siya. Plus non-cash expenses. And there are non-cash income that has been reported in the income statement but there is no involvement of cash. Example, unrealized gains. Unrealized gains that is coming from the changes in fair value, let's say for the fair value to profit or loss. And the changes in the fair value to profit or loss as far as changes in fair value is concerned, when it goes upwards, so there is an unrealized gain. And that unrealized gain should be accounted under profit or loss. So that account increases the net income reported in your income statement. However, there is no involvement of cash. And we are under cash flows. Therefore, the amount that increases the net income after tax, wherein there is no cash involvement, there are no cash involvement, should be deducted. Ang galing natin. Kasi wala namang cash involvement. Therefore, kapag ginawa mo net income after tax reported under accrual basis plus the cash expenses minus the non-cash income, there you go. There is now the net income under cash basis. Okay? And to determine the operating activities, you will observe the movement of your current assets and current liabilities. And the problem now lies here. Dito kayo nalilito. The increase in current assets should be, the increase represents the increment. Huh? Okay, the difference between the beginning and the ending. If your receivable is 100 and beginning and ending is 200, there is an increase of 100. That is your increase in current asset. No? If there is an increase in current asset, that should be deducted. The increase in current asset should be deducted. Siyempre, the decrease in current asset should be added. While if that is a current liabilities, the increase in current liabilities will be added while the decrease should be deducted. Coming from here, net income under cash basis plus minus, you can now account for the operating activity. Okay? However, class, dito ka nga nalilito. Kasi dito, one miss, you die. Sa board exam, nandun ang pressure. Minsan, kahit dalawa na lang yan, ano na ba ang gagawin pag increase in current asset? O, ibabawas ba o idadagdag? Those are the items or the point of consideration na pwedeng magpalito sa'yo come board exam. Na kailangan mo ng concept para ma-establish mo ulit yung sarili mo, come to the point na nalito ka. Idadagdag ba o ibabawas? Walang libro na nagpaliwanag nito. Ipapakita ko sa iyo ngayon, why is that? The increase in current asset should be deducted and while the decrease should be added. The same as the movement of your current liabilities. Let's go back to the basic here. Bakit ang increase ng current asset ay ibinabawas? Bakit ang decrease ng current asset ay idinadagdag? Okay, ito yon. Okay, so the most common items para mapadali tayo na current asset, ipasok mo na lang si accounts receivable. Okay? Oh, let's say ganito yung nangyari. So let's start with this. Whenever that the current asset increases, okay, the increment or the increase should be deducted. Why is that? Ito yon. Let's say we have an AR here. An AR is part of your current assets. The normal balance is a debit balance. You have your beginning here of 10 and the ending here of 20. Okay? So, ito na. So, from 10, naging 20. Diba? That is an increase in AR. That is increase in current asset. By how much? By 10 pesos. O, tingnan mo. 10 naging 20. Bakit kaya? Kasi meron dito 10. Ano yan? 10 na yan. Diba? That is the sales on account. Okay? And sales on account is what? There is no cash involvement. What is the entry here? Diba? Debit AR and credit sales. O, tingnan mo. Because of this entry, because of this transaction, that there is a sale that increases the net income, diba? That increases the net income after tax using the accrual basis, pero walang involvement ng cash. Okay? Because of this transaction, again, beginning is 10, 20 is the ending balance. Okay? Kulang ang debit mo na magkano 10 piso. And what is that? That is the net sales on account. Debit AR credit sales. Because of this entry, the sales figure here increases the net income. However, there is no involvement of cash. That is why the increase in current asset should be deducted. What about if there is a decreaser? Okay. So, 10 naging 5. E di nag-decrease. 10 naging 5. Nag-decrease. Anong kulang mo? Ito, credit side. Babalansin ko yung debits and credits. And what is that 5? That is collection. Okay, what is the entry for that? Debit cash, credit AR. So, since nag-debit ka ng cash, that should be an increase in cash. Therefore, the increment should be added. Okay, so the decrease in current asset should be added. Okay? So, isa lang ang ma-establish mo, okay na eh. Pag nalito ka sa board exam, balik ka dito sa basic. Ah, pag na-establish mo na that the increase in current asset should be a deduction, okay ka na doon. Kasi yung kabaliktaran nun, addition. Di ba? How about for current liab? Why is that? The increase in current liability should be added. And what is that? Why is that? The decrease in current liability should be deducted. Let's go hypothetical figures here. The famous okay, liability account is accounts payable. Example, 5 ang beginning accounts payable mo. Naging 10. E di nag-increase. Bakit kaya nag-increase? Dahil dito. Ano yan? That is your net purchases. What is the entry? Debit purchases and credit accounts payable. This purchases is an item of expense that decreases your net income pero walang involvement ng cash. Therefore, that should be added back. Okay? Nakuha. Walang involvement ng cash. This purchases decreases the net income pero walang involvement ng cash. Therefore, ibalik. Okay? So, the increase in current liabilities should be added. Okay? How about, sir, the decrease that should be deducted? Can you prove it? Yes. Beginning is 5. Accounts payable while the ending is 2. What happened? Kulang ang debit mo by 3. And what is that? Payment. What is the entry? Debit accounts payable, credit cash. There is what? An outflow of cash. Therefore, that should be deducted. Yun ang nature nito ng changes ng current assets and current liabilities mo. Please have time, no? Na ipasok mo to sa sistema mo para in the event na malito ka sa board exam, meron kang panggagalingan na konsepto. Okay? Pag na-establish mo na yan, kahit isa lang dyan, okay ka na. Okay? Kasi ito lang naman yan eh. Pag na-establish mo to, increase in current asset, binabawas, definitely, ito yon. Decrease should be added. Nakuha. Hindi naman pwedeng pareho eh, di ba? Increase in current asset should be deducted. Definitely, ang decrease idadagdag. O, ito. Pag na-establish mo to, na increase in current asset deducted, definitely ang increase ng current liability, iba sila, magkaiba. 'Di ba? Hindi naman parehong pwede 'yon. Ito current asset, asset ito, ito liability. 'Di ba? So, meaning the increase in current asset is it deducted, so the increase in current liability should be added. 'Di ba? Ganun 'yon. Okay? Then, syempre, ito naman, increase ng current asset added, yung kabaliktaran naman nito, pag nag-decrease, hindi naman dapat added. That should be deducted. Kaya nga, isa lang naman ang i-establish mo eh. Ito lang, increase ng current asset. Isang concept lang ang kailangan mo, ito. Okay? Pag nalito ka, balik ka dito. Okay? Paano na nga ba yun? Provide ka lang ng T-account. 10, naging 20, nag-increase. Okay? So, nag-increase. Bakit kaya? Kasi merong 10 na dinebit. Ano kaya yun? Sales. Ayun, net sales yun. That increases the net income pero wala namang involvement ng cash. Ano gagawin? Bawasan. Yun yun. Pag na-establish mo na yun, automatic na yan. Okay? The decrease should be deducted. Okay? The CL added, increase in CL, hindi sila pwede magpareho niyan. So that should be added. Okay? Kasi ito bawas ka na eh. Therefore, the decrease here should be deducted. Yun lang naman. Kasi there are numerous, no? Events or situations na yan ang naging problema in the board exam. Kaya tinagalan ko yung discussion dito. Kasi ayoko mabiktima ka rin nun. Okay? Pag nagawa mo na yan, simple na lang yung mga kasunod. Okay, let's now go to Excel. Excel tayo. Okay. So sa Excel natin, ito yun, no? Indirect method. Ito yung template natin. Net income after tax plus the non-cash expense minus the non-cash income. This is now your net income under cash basis. Ang requirement dyan, class, what is the cash flows under operating activities? Paano mo, sir, nasabing indirect ito? Okay? Kasi wala namang diretsong inflow and outflow of cash. Ang binigay sa'yo dito are what? These are the related accounts na current assets and current liabilities. Okay? Then it says here that the CURT reported a reported profit of 88 for the year after depreciations of 200 and the gain on sale of 240 and the restructuring and other provisions of 400. None of the provisions recognized during the affected cash. Magkano ang cash flows from operations? O nagsimula sa net income mo, reported under accrual basis na magkano? 8,800. Okay? Pero class, as a matter of advice, pag nakita mo na ganito, saan ba dapat talaga ang simula mo? Ang simula mo talaga dyan is to determine the effect of the changes in your assets and liabilities. So meaning, saan ka magsisimula? Yung nasa ilalim muna, the changes in your current assets and current liabilities. Yan ang simula mo. Yan nandito sa ilalim. Okay, dun tayo mag-start. Ito yon. You have your AR here. Okay? So neto mo na. NRB na tayo. So this is 15,6 tsaka 19. 16 minus 100, 20 minus 1. So 15,6 siya beginning. Tapos yan ay naging 19. So ano nangyari? Nag-increase. Okay? By how much? That is 19 minus 15,6. Nag-increase yan, sir, ng 3,400. Okay? So increase in current asset of, ano ba yan? Increase in current asset of 3,400. Okay, tanong. Under the indirect cash flows, the increase in current asset of 3,4, will this be added or deducted? Letter A or D lang sa chat box. Okay, will this be added or deducted? The increase in current assets or the increase in AR should be added or deducted. Diba, kailangan ma-establish mo yan. So that should be deducted. How much? That is 3,4. Ito yun. Kasi ito kailangan natin eh, na ilalagay natin dito. Okay? Then we have the prepaid rent. So 3,840 and we have 3,200. So what happened? There is a decrease. By how much? The decrease is 840 minus 200, that is 640. Okay. What is now the treatment here? Prepaid rent is an asset. Okay? Therefore, the decrease in current asset, what should be made? Is that added or deducted in our cash flow? So that should be decrease in current assets should be added. So ito na yun, 640. Then we have the accounts payable here, amounting to 6,800 beginning and the ending of 8,800. So there is what? An increase amounting to 2,000 pesos. What should be the accounting treatment here? The increase in current liability should be added or deducted. Chat box, please. That should be added. Therefore, the net effect of this, this is minus 334 plus 640 and 2,000 positive. So the net effect is negative 760. So meaning, ito yung kailangan mo dito. Ano yun? That is your minus 760. Okay? So let's now account for this. Then you have the depreciation, which is a non-cash expense. Okay? So depreciation is a non-cash expense. Okay, ano pa? Dito muna ako sa provisions. Provisions, non-cash expense din yan. Di ba nag-usap tayo related to provisions? Example, warranties. Di ba? That is debit warranty expense and credit estimated warranty liability. You have your premiums, debit premium expense and credit estimated warranty liability. Therefore, there is the presence of expense, but there is no cash involvement. Therefore, this 400 is what? A non-cash expense also. So what are the non-cash expenses? You have the 200 here, depreciation, and the 400 here. So the non-cash expense that should be added, that is 600,000. 600 pesos. Okay. Here, the gain on sale class. Oh. The gain on sale is treated to be as what? The gain on sale is treated to be as a non-cash income. Maraming, ano to? Maraming tanong sa akin, bakit sir nagiging non-cash yan? Eh di ba nagbenta ka, may gain ka nga sir. Di ba dapat may cash? Ang daming tanong lagi. Paliwanag na natin, no? O, tingnan mo ha. Meron gain na 240. Gawa na lang ako ng hypothetical example. Okay? This is your sales carrying value gain. Ang gain dyan ay sinasabi niyang for 240. Okay? O, palabasin natin. Let's say the carrying value here is 1,000. Okay? Then you have your sales of 1,240. These are just hypothetical figures, yung 1,240 tsaka 100. Examples lang ito or figures para mag-derive si 240 gain. O, ganito yun. So this is 240. So hypothetical figures would mean that there is, for example, a carrying value of 100,000 and a sale of 1,240. Okay? O sir, tingnan mo na, may sale dyan sir. Ibig sabihin sir, may pumasok dyan na cash. Why is that sir? This is treated to be as a non-cash income. Oh, eh, kahit na entryhan natin. Oh, sige. Pag in-entryhan mo yan, so debit ka ng cash eh. Okay? 1,240 dito. Okay? Ano yung tinapon mo? Is 1,240. Ang tinapon mo dyan, equipment, di ba? Okay, yung value nilang gamitin natin. Huwag na natin pahabain na may accumulated depreciation pa siya. Ito yon. So, 1,000. O, di ba? Ito, gain. O, gain. On sale. Amounting to 240. Yan, sir. O, tingnan mo. O, di ba may cash dyan? O, bakit hindi natin, bakit natin trinit, sir, as non-cash income yan? O, tingnan natin, ha? Remember that this is a disposal of equipment. And we are asked to compute what is the cash flows from operating activities. Chat box, please. Itong cash na to, under cash flow, saang activity yan? Disposal yan ng equipment. This is part of your what? What activity? Investing activity yan. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng cash, kinuha na ng investing activity. Nakuha. Ibig sabihin, ikaw, na nagko-compute ng operating activity, hindi pwedeng dumoble. The whole cash was already considered as part of your investing activity. There is Therefore, there is no cash flow related to this as far as financing and operating. Kasi kinain na mismo ni investing activity. Kaya itong 240 mo, wag mong sabihin operating activity yan because the whole 1,240 is now included as part of your investing activity. That is why this 240 now becomes a non-cash income. Okay? Kaya mo siya binabawas. So that is 8,800 plus your 600 minus 240. There you go. You have your amount here. That is 9,160. 9,160 minus the 760 here. We have now 8,400. Okay? That is item 9. Then we have here the last item under cash flow. Okay? And a board exam problem. So this is your net cash flows used in investing activities and financing activities. Madali na to. Kasi alam mo na mag-classify. Parang ganito. Remember that the cash flow statement reflects the inflow and outflow of cash and cash equivalents. Again, reflects the inflow and outflow of cash and cash equivalents. Therefore, ito kayang bullet one. Meron kayang effect sa cash flow natin that we've acquired the 3-month treasury bill of 200,000 pesos. Okay? This 3-month treasury bill is what? This is a cash equivalence, di ba? Okay? Would this transaction affect our cash flows? Nag-acquire ka ng T-bills amounting to 200,000. So you have your cash equivalence. Paano ka nakakuha yan? Nagbayad ka ng cash na magkano na 200,000 din. So if cash flow is a statement related to the inflow and outflow of cash, inflow and outflow of cash, would the first bullet here affect our cash flow? Yes or no? May pumasok na cash equivalent, may lumabas na cash. Okay? May pumasok na cash equivalent, may lumabas na cash. You have debited a cash equivalent and credited cash. And the cash flow is what? A statement that reflects the inflow and outflow of cash. My question now, as far as the bottom line is concerned, okay, nagkaroon ba ng effect ng cash flow natin yan? Wala. Kasi pumasok si cash equivalent, lumabas si cash of the same amount, boom, zero. Okay, nag-offset. So walang effect sa cash flow natin si bullet 1. Let's now go to bullet 2. Si bullet 2 natin, meron ka dito equipment na binili. Acquired equipment, 4 million yan. The purchase price is 4 million. Pero wag mo kagad i-assume na this is an investing activity. Okay? Baka kasi inutang eh. O, diba? O, kailangan kasi ma-establish natin yung cash involvement. Ito na nga, by paying 20% in cash. Therefore, ang cash involvement lang dito is only what? 20% lang. And the other daw, and issuing a note payable for the balance. So therefore, 20% of 4 million, that is 20%, that is 800,000. Okay, outflow ito ah, outflow. Kasi bumili ka eh. So ibig sabihin, binayad mo yung pera. So kaya ito naka-negative that it's just a representation that this is an outflow of cash. Okay? There were no payments made on the second of the note during the second year. Okay, ito na to. What is now the classification of this outflow of 800,000? Is that an investing, operating, or financing? Chat box, please. You've acquired an equipment here. Remember, tanong dyan, may pera ka ba? Yes. May pera ka. Nga lang, hanggang 20% lang. So this is an investing activity. Okay? Let's proceed. It says here that acquired land with fair value of 3.2 by issuing shares with aggregate par and the excess is credited to premium. Plus, kung i-entryhan mo yan, Automatic yan. That is what? Non-cash eh. Wala eh. Walang involvement ng cash. May land ka. Nag-issue ka ng shares. Tapos credited the excess to share premium amounting to 800,000. Diba? Walang cash involvement. So, bullet 3 is a non-cash transaction. Okay? Non-cash transaction yung bullet 3. How about here? Bullet 4. Extended a 1.6 loan to a director. Merong cash? Yes. May pera ka ba dyan? May pera ka ba dyan? Ikaw ba ang nagpa-utang? Yes. If that is the case, 1.6 million is what activity? Would that be an operating, investing, or financing? Investing, kasi may pera ka. And this is again a outflow. Okay? So, nasa na yun? Basta nandyan lang yun. Okay? So remember, we have here, this is negative 800,000 and the 1.6 extended to the director of 1.6. Okay? So dito na lang lagay. 1.6. Investing activity. Okay? Okay. Next, borrowed 1 million. Borrowed 1 million. Ito pala, 1.6. Lipat ko. This is 1.6 extended to a director. This is investing. Game. Next, borrowed 1.28 million loan. Nanghiram ka ng pera. Okay? And that money is what? A complete transaction. Nanghiram ka eh. Magkano hiniram mo? 1.28 million pesos. Okay? So what activity is that? Ito, this is a complete transaction eh. Borrowed 1.28 million from a bank, period. Oh, that is a complete transaction. What activity is that? Kailangan mo ng pera eh. So that is financing activity. Okay? So 1.28 million is a financing activity. Next. Kung paano mo gagamitin itong 1.28 million, that is now another story. O, ibang kwento na yan. Okay, paano niya ginamit? 800,000, sir. Ginamit daw saan? Sa kanyang operations. Additional working capital. No? 800,000 for additional working capital. Therefore, this is an operating activity. Ginamit sa operations. Okay, tapos meron pa. The 480,000 ginamit saan? For the payment of scrip dividends. And that dividends is part of your retained earnings and part of the equity. Therefore, what activity now is this negative 480,000? Chat box, please. That would be a component of your equity. And again, ano yung sabi natin under the concept map? Wala kang pera, financing, and items affecting equity. Therefore, this is a financing activity. Okay? Next, settlement of outstanding note payable by issuing shares with aggregate par value of 800,000. Share premium resulted from the transaction amounted to 280. And again, the last bullet is a non-cash transaction. Okay? What has been made to settle the note payable is the issuance of shares, and any excess should be accounted under an account share premium. So bullet, last bullet is a non-cash transaction. So let's now go to the requirement. The requirement is to determine how much the net cash inflow or use under investing activity. And we have here 800,000 outflow and 1.6 million outflow. Therefore, the answer in number 10, this is an outflow of 2.4 million pesos. Okay? Next, item 11, financing activities naman. We have here inflow of 1,280 and an outflow of 480 here. So 1,280, okay, minus this 480,000. Therefore, there is a net inflow of 800,000, which is your answer in number 11. Answers again, Number 10, an outflow of 2.4 in number 10, while in number 11, an inflow of 800,000 pesos. And that is now your cash flows. Okay? The next one, last na to for this day, no? Kasi mabibitin tayo kapag pinag-usapan natin yung accounting for income tax. By next meeting class, no? Parang async yun. Maglo-load ako ng video doon, pero I will not discuss the accounting for income tax. The accounting for income tax will be discussed on a synchronous basis. Maraming nahihirapan doon eh. Okay? Ano pa yung mga ano natin? Mga crucial topics, no? I'm seeing one, the accounting for income tax. Then the leases, no? Yan, magkakasama yan, i-discuss ko. Okay, siguro pagsamahin ko si income tax, leases. Sa leases, dalawa yan, the lessor and the lessee. Okay? So, unahin na natin ngayon sino? Si operating segment. Okay? Operating segment tayo.